Welcome to our 5-on-5. Please be joined by State Representative and Republican candidate for Governor Knute Buehler. Good to see you.
Nice to see you, Craig.
Thanks for being here. So you released your education plan recently. In it, you propose extending the school year by 15 days and increasing the budget by at least 15%. How are you going to pay for that?
Yeah, great question. I think it's really important that we rescue our kids, our teachers, and our public school from a funding crisis, a classroom funding crisis, and a graduation crisis. And we're going to pay for it in two ways. One, I want to increase the K-12 budget. We've underfunded the K-12 budget for years. I want to increase it 15%. But those dollars just don't go into any pot. They go into really targeted outcomes, and one is increasing the school year. Right now, we have one of the shortest school years in the entire nation. Give you an example of the impact that has. If you're a kid who goes to school in Oregon, by the time you're done as a senior, you'll be in school a year shorter than if that kid was going to school in Washington. So we need to restore that lost school year. And that's a big goal. And the second way we're going to pay for it is we need real retirement benefit reform. We need to really make sure that the dollars get into the classroom, get into the kids, and not into retirement benefits.
You responded to a pretty scathing foster care audit earlier this year by calling for $50 million to make the fixes that were recommended by auditors. Is that enough to fix our foster care system?
It's really important that we rescue our foster kids from a system that is horribly broken. Now, these are 8,000 of the most vulnerable kids in this state, kids who really have nowhere else to turn. And my proposal in the February session was to allocate $50 million for a rapid improvement team to implement those 24 recommendations that were outlined in the audit. Now, this has been a long time in coming and something that Governor Brown has really failed to lead. This problem needs to be solved.
There's been a lot of concern from Oregon's congressional leadership in Washington, D.C., the senators specifically, of course. Do you think any change on the Supreme Court will affect health care in Oregon?
I don't think so. I think we have a broad consensus in Oregon that the Medicaid expansion population really needs to be covered. Those people who got increased access to health care with the Affordable Care Act. Now, certainly there needs to be improvements and reform of the Affordable Care Act, and we'll work on those when I become governor. But people's health care in Oregon is safe with me as their governor.
We're going to take a quick commercial break. Sure. We'll have much more in just a moment. Stay with us. Welcome back to our 5-on-5. Again, we're here with Oregon State Representative and Republican candidate for Governor Knute Buehler. As you know, homelessness is a huge problem across Oregon, and it also is here in Southern Oregon. How would you fix that if elected governor?
Yeah, homelessness is a problem we have to fix. It is a humanitarian crisis, it's a public health crisis, and increasingly it's a public safety crisis. We need to move our homeless off the streets, off the sidewalks, into shelters and into treatment specifically. That is a high priority. In my opinion, no one in Oregon's home should be a tent or a sidewalk. That's a big problem that we need to fix. And there are cities around the state that are doing this well. Tillamook is doing it well. Bend. And the real solution here is getting a roof over people's head, housing first, and then sort through how they ended up on the street.
Does Oregon need to rethink the kicker rebate?
I think we need to rethink our revenue stream. You know, our problem right now is not that we don't have enough tax revenue, but that it cycles too much, that it peaks and valleys. And right now we're in a peak, but we're going to see a valley at some point. So we need to have a rainy day fund that actually takes care of those peaks and valleys. And then we need to get our costs under control so that they're going up less than our revenue. And that would put the state back on a stable fiscal condition.
Okay, obviously you've been here in town. One of the places you're going is the Jackson County Fair. What was that like for you? I guess it's a priority. You got to go out and meet the people. Is that an experience you think that will help your candidacy?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I grew up in Southern Oregon, so I like to be out meeting people, listening to learn, hearing what their concerns are. And we've been doing that the whole campaign, especially after we won the primary. And what I'm hearing is two things. People really love this state. They're proud of it. It really starts with our natural beauty, and we need to preserve that. But there's also a sense of unhappiness, of unease, that we have underperforming state government and a governor who's not solving the big problems facing the state.
Good to see you.
Yeah,
thanks for meeting.
Nice to see you, Craig.
Appreciate it.
Thanks a lot.
Stay with us. We'll be right back.